Subscribe and press the bell icon to never miss an update from First Post.
Why would you create broccoli?
Broccoli is slightly juicier.
You like broccoli? How can you like broccoli?
This is a world where people have created dubstep.
I still prefer dubstep.
Hello and welcome to Social Media Star. I'm Janice Iquera. My guests for today, Abhishek Bachchan, Varun Grover. Let me just start off. You guys know each other. I believe you've never met.
I know of him. I've just met him. I'm very excited. Yeah.
I've never
he's not
met
heard
him.
Of me or
I have
met me.
Of course, heard of him and
so he's a bit confused. Who's he?
So Abhishek gets like this. I expect him to talk a lot during the episode.
Okay, nahi, hum log Banaras bonding kar chuke hain.
Haan ji.
Acha, so I made sure we all have coffee because I know the two of you have been having sleepless nights.
Yes.
Abhishek is tweeting till 3 in the morning, courtesy of the FIFA World Cup.
And jet lag.
And jet lag. Yeah. And our man has Sacred Games out, so all the reviews have been pouring in.
Yeah.
Varun, what I like about your account is that despite the fact that you're a writer and lyricist working in the film industry, you're still not afraid to call out people on their bullshit. I mean, you'll talk about sexism in the industry, you'll talk about the wage gap, you'll talk about credits. I'm trying to understand, has this, for lack of a better word, mufatness led to sort of awkward encounters with industry walas?
Not really. Because one, I started doing it when I had nothing to lose, kind of a situation. I started as a comedian before I became a writer. Okay, I've been a stand-up comedian from 2009-10. A pro from 2012. My first film came out in 2015, which is Masaan. So, usse pehle tak, I treated myself as a stand-up comedian who is also writing films. But मेरा पहला धर्म है मैं stand-up comedian हूँ मैं सब में जो भी मुझे गलती दिख रही है मैं उसको point out करूँगा in my own whatever humorous way or satirical way. And then once Masaan got great reviews, it you know went to Cannes and all that. And after that, like in that one year in 2015, Masaan came out, Dam Laga Ke Haisha came out, which you know again the album was
beautiful,
like well received and all. So then I felt I have gained that stability where nobody can, you know, throw me out for my views.
Abhishek,
may I weigh in
sure,
on this?
Sure, of course.
I just, you know, I think there's a huge misconception and misrepresentation about the film industry that happens a lot of the time. First of all, if he has an opinion, he's allowed to share. There's no rule saying you can't say what you want to say. The film industry, by fact of the function of what it does, we're filmmakers. We make films for an audience, for the public. If you're talented, which he is immensely, nobody's going to care what he tweets about if it's against somebody in particular, if you're going to give them what they want. It's a business. People forget that.
What did you make of the Junior Bachchan parody account with a double C and a double H?
Well, whoever he or she is, I think they're very creative. You know, I don't get affected by these things. I mean, I've always said, if you can't stand the heat, get out of the kitchen, you know. You have to learn to laugh at yourself. And that's the way I've been brought up, you know. What I think is not cool is, you know, sometimes when you reply back and then all they have is abuse as an answer, then you've already lost the argument, you know, the minute you start abusing, then it's no more fun. If you're going to get into a fun repartee, then I'm all game for it, you know. Bring
so
it on.
Any more trolls want to get into a fun repartee, Abhishek Bachchan's all game.
I enjoy it.
I don't know if you guys have noticed this about your own profiles or not, but some weird stuff that I observed. So Abhishek, literally every second or third tweet on your timeline is a happy birthday wish.
That I tweet?
Yeah. I mean, I think if you go back and look at your timeline, especially in the last 1 month, it's like
I just did one on the way here.
Oh wow! What is with this weird obsession of wishing people a happy birthday on Twitter?
I'll tell you why this happened. Okay, so I have this one idol in my life. He's a sports person. His name is Magic Johnson. He's a basketball player. He used to play for the LA Lakers. And one of the biggest days for me was I think it was either 21st or 22nd of April. 2010 or 11, and he followed me on Twitter, and I had wished him on his birthday, and you know that's how I discovered him, and then one day he followed me back and he wished me for my birthday and for Aradhya's birth, and I was just on top of the moon because this is like my idol, and I'm like wow, I'm like if you can give that to somebody, why not?
Fair enough, that's a good point. Varun, coming to you. You have 69,000 tweets to your name, and I did a bit of math on this.
You tweet once every 2 hours?
That's an average of 22 times a day.
But a lot of them are replies to people.
So are you one of those who likes to answer everybody?
I used to before 2014.
I started off like that as well, then I couldn't keep up.
Yeah. Now I kind of now
then
I
you realize a lot of them you should just well left.
हाँ नहीं अब मैं जवाब ट्वीट करने के बजाय बोल देता हूँ और टाइप नहीं करता.
अच्छा. That also works. Put it out there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you're waiting to your laptop.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why not?
To the guy, and then hoping somehow, you know, by some magic, that person understands what I didn't write.
Okay, guys. So for social media confessions this week, I thought let's do something different with the two of you. So I went onto the internet and I decided to see what are the random questions people are asking about the two of you. Question number one: is Varun Grover related to Sunil Grover?
Yes. And Gulshan Grover. Happy. Ancestrally, we all come from the same lineage. Yes,
there is someone left. There is someone left. No, I am not related to anyone. I am not related to anyone. At one point of time, my dadi wanted me to find a connection to Gulshan Grover when I just moved to Bombay. And dadi ko bada tension tha na ki naukri aukri chhod ke kahan hai Bombay chala gaya. She said ki hum na pata karte hain, koi to hoga dur dur ka rishtedar, koi Gulshan Grover se tera connection bitha denge to jaake usse kaam mang lena. Maine kaha nahi, mere ko nahi zarurat hai. I'm not related.
What a sweet dadi ji. Yeah. What would happen if Abhishek Bachchan met Sheldon Cooper from the Big Bang Theory?
I'd take a selfie with him. I brushed past him once in New York.
Really?
Yeah. I was quite.
But you didn't stop him and take a selfie.
No, then. I get conscious to like disturb them because you know I mean you just say give them their privacy. But how cool would that be?
Yeah.
I'd stop him this time for and say I'm really sorry, but yeah, I need to show off and I need to increase my followers Instagram, please.
So why does stand-up comedian Varun Grover call the Indian Prime Minister in bracket Shri Modi a liar all of the time on every platform?
Okay, not all of the time, like 70% of the times.
Only 70.
Yeah. Because, and I don't think he's a liar, he's a manipulator. कुछ चीज़ें हैं जो कि हाफ ट्रूथ हैं, वो आप घुमा के ऐसे बोल रहे हैं कि लोग सच मान लें. एंड ही इज़ अ वंडरफुल ओरेटर विच ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ हिज लेक्चर्स
स्पीचेस बीइंग कवर्ड
एंड देन ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ हिज
लाइफ. There you go, Kora, that's why. Why Abhishek Bachchan never tried to have six-pack? This is not my bad English, this is how it was written on Kora.
I'm trying, it's very tough, man. Koi mithai aapke samne rakh de.
Haan, bilkul.
To khana to padega na.
Is Varun Grover married? Now, I have to tell you, this wasn't just on Kora, this was on Yahoo Answers, this was on random, if I just went into the Google search button. Why is the internet so obsessed with knowing whether you're married or not?
I have no
idea. Are you married?
Yes, I am married.
Congratulations.
And, congratulations.
Married with one human and three cats.
Let's move on to likes and dislikes. A millennial word that you think should be banned.
Okay, not banned, but I just don't understand bae. Okay, B-A-E. I just don't understand. It's before anybody else or something.
Yes, before anybody else.
But how do you pronounce it bae when, you know, for a UP wala, bae is always a bae or bae idhar aao aur woh sab. Toh woh bada mujhe confusing lagta hai ki hum itne time se jis cheez pe apna haq jama ke baithe the. उसको आपने ये क्यूट वर्ड कैसे बना दिया? आई डोंट लाइक दैट.
राइट, सो दिस इज द रॉन्ग टाइम फॉर मी टू से दैट आई थॉट बे वाज एक्चुअली टेकन फ्रॉम अ यूपी बे. मींस सडनली द यूपी हैज बिकम, यू नो, वी बिकम इंटरनेशनल.
अच्छा अभिषेक, व्हिच इज व्हाट यू एक्चुअली यूज?
आई एम करंटली ट्राइंग टू इनकॉर्पोरेट सिक इनटू माय वोकैबुलरी. आई मीन नॉट वोकैबुलरी बट इनटू माय सेंटेंसेस द वे दे यूज इट. माय नीस नव्या कीप्स सेइंग ओ मामू, यू नो दैट स्टोरी इज सिक. So it takes me like that millisecond now to process.
Ah.
So I'm trying to get used to that.
Okay, a selfie pose that needs to go out of fashion.
I'm really bad at this. I get a major complex, especially with my dear friend Karan Johar, because Karan is just amazing at it.
So like when you go like this, what do you do?
I don't know. I'm very awkward. Yeah, so just to irritate people when they come for selfies, because there've been times and nothing but love for people who've done this. But you know, somebody will come, especially, you know, some of these girls, okay, we have a selfie, and then wo aapko thama dete hain. And suddenly you start feeling that you're the prop instead of being the celebrity. You know, they can't find the right person. Like, oh, you take it, you have longer arms.
Yeah.
But Abhishek, to be fair, you are the tallest.
Look, I'm 6'3", I have long arms, man. So it doesn't mean if you're going to come and ask for a photograph with me, don't ask me to take the photograph. And I'm really bad at it. I'm good at being shot, as they will admit. I don't know how to take photographs. So just to irritate them now, I just put it down here. and I click it, and everybody, anybody who knows anything about vanity knows that this is the worst angle. So just to irritate them, I put it down here. Also, is this easiest? And what makes me very conscious, they completely cozy up to you. Has that happened to you?
Yeah, yeah, all the time.
Can I have a selfie with you? I'm like, sure. So I'm standing there and they're like... And I somehow really, I get, then all hell breaks loose inside my head and my inner voices start going nuts. And suddenly I started bringing my wedding ring into the photograph. You know? Don't think what it is, it's not. Or I just become like really stiff. The only time I've said no aggressively was I was in the bathroom once and somebody wanted to take a selfie with me.
Where?
In the bathroom. At like, the urinal.
Okay. At
like public.
I mean, I'm actually doing this. I'm sorry, but and they're like, sir, ek selfie. I'm like, can I just finish?
This was in India?
No, this is in India.
Okay.
But what happened next was even better. Yes, yes, of course. So, what's going on? So, I was like, just give me 15 seconds. Trust me, I haven't had that much water. Just 15 seconds.
Varun, आपके साथ हुआ है ये कभी ऐसे?
Airport पे मैं अभी उतरा हूँ और मैं अभी luggage belt पे अपना सामान का wait कर रहा हूँ. One guy comes and instead of asking for a selfie, this guy says, एक selfie हो जाए. हो जाए मतलब चाय है रसगुल्ले क्या है हो जाए क्या होता है लाइक मतलब और उससे पहले कि मैं कुछ बोल पाऊं ही जस्ट टुक आउट द कैमरा ही क्लिक द फोटो ही वेंट आई लाइक ओके फक इट मैं अपना सामान लेके मैं जब बाहर निकल रहा हूं अगेन ही कम्स रनिंग बैक टू मी सेइंग आपका नाम क्या है मैं कंफ्यूज हो रहा हूं आप वरुण ठाकुर हैं कि वरुण ग्रोवर हैं
So this is a segment I like to call What Were They Thinking? So I pick a tweet or a post that I thought was funny and I want to ask you about it. So Abhishek Bachchan on 27th May, What the F Facts tweeted that broccoli was actually man-made, to which you replied, Why would anyone do such a thing? All caps, why? I mean, who even likes broccoli? You didn't stop there. On June 11th, when someone tagged you in a coffee plus broccoli latte tweet, like what is that? You tweeted, and hashtag broccoli continues to wage its war against mankind. Why? How badly have you been scarred by broccoli, man?
Who is not scarred by broccoli and Brussels sprouts?
I'm really not scarred.
You like broccoli? So you want to know karma? Here's karma. I wrote that tweet about broccoli, and for lunch, I get served broccoli with quinoa.
You tweeted about this.
And then what the media did after that was the best. Aishwarya ka badla Abhishek par and all that. Can you imagine they actually had this visual of Aishwarya in the kitchen making broccoli for me, which I thought was really funny. I mean, poor thing. Aishwarya is the one who started like making sure that I ate vegetables and broccoli was one of them.
So you could just have said, I don't want to eat broccoli. Sure, it's not like a dictatorship that you have to eat broccoli.
Married life and, you know, happiness in that is also very important.
You don't like any fruit?
No, I hate fruit. And I've only found not one more mangoes. Normal person on is my most hated fruit.
What? Mango?
Mangoes. But why would somebody invent broccoli? I can understand if God says, okay, here, ye phal hai, ye, you know, a vegetable, kha lo. Okay, why would you mutate a cauliflower to make it green to start off? It just blows my mind. Why would you create broccoli?
AB, you know you're a minority, right? People are watching this, going to watch this episode and go like, that guy is weird.
No, one second. Okay, guys, in the show, who likes broccoli over here? Like, oh, broccoli, yay. Are you serious?
Were
you dropped as a child? What's wrong with you?
I like broccoli.
How can you like it? Does it taste
like
anything?
He likes broccoli too.
I mean, this is a world where people have created dubstep, so I think broccoli is fine.
I still prefer dubstep.
Let's move on from the broccoli debate. Varun Grover, on 13th June at 8:52 p.m., you shared a video where your cat was getting what looked like a violent massage with this tweet. Anybody else has a crazy cat that loves getting massage style pats? Yeah. Instead of cuddles and belly rubs.
Yeah.
Chenna Poda demands a
Chenna nahi. Chenna.
Chenna Poda. Your cat demands it through the day. And then you ended it with this. Is he a BDSM cat? Firstly, I just want to say that if your cat had rights, he would sue you for putting up that video. Okay? I mean, what was that video?
If you had told me, I would have got Chenna Poda here and demonstrated it. And you would have seen how much he loves it. But yeah, it's a bit of a weird cat. Everybody wants to know that their kids are special, even if they are not. You know, you want to believe that.
Yeah. Even if your kids don't eat broccoli and mangoes and vegetables.
So we keep looking for things ki acha hamari ye cat kaise unique hai.
We are definitely putting a Chennapoda video over here.
Chennapoda, she invaded a South Indian word now all of a sudden. Poda is Tamil, by the way.
Yeah.
Poda.
Okay.
So this is very obviously a very North Indian kind.
Correct. Yeah, I'm clearly not getting the pronunciation right. But between broccoli debates and BDSM cats, you guys have been absolute sports. I've got some gifts from our friends at Steve Madden, Abhishek Bachchan.
Thank you.
Arun Grover.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being on Social Media Star. I hope you like the shoes.
Thanks very much.
And thank you, Fable Mumbai, for your wonderful hospitality.